Now, with the housing market going gangbusters in your neighbourhood, here's a reminder for those looking to buy a new place.
Not everything about a house is listed in the building report, and sometimes what the agent isn't telling you may give you cause to think twice.
Despite all the dire warnings, it's a pretty good time to be in real estate. Buyers are queuing up and houses are selling like hotcakes.
It's going.
But what if your brand new pad has a dark secret?
They're here.
Maybe things are going bump in the night. And while you may not believe in ghosts...
Do you believe in ghosts?
Not really.
Plenty of other people do. Just last week, the Herald reported that Ghostbusters were brought into a South Auckland property to rid it of evil spirits. And the agents, well, they didn't say boo about it.
And with us now is Bindi Norwell from the Real Estate Institute. Good to talk to you, Bindi. Now, I know this is a bit weird, but have you ever heard of agents dealing with hauntings or paranormal goings-on?
Look, it doesn't happen very often. It's very rare. I could probably count the times on one hand. So, yeah, not very often.
Right. What about if the house has a dark past? Say, a murder took place or something like that. Would the agent have to disclose that?
Well, I mean, I guess, yes, they do. And they don't need to put it in the marketing material up front. But, yes, if someone's really serious about buying a property, they do need to disclose that. And I think it's just the right thing to do. And I always use the neighbour test. You don't want to find out something significant about the property from your neighbour.
So what else do agents need to disclose? What should they disclose?
Well, I think it's really important that people ask the questions, and you can ask, well, what other information do I need to know about the property? You need to ask things such as, you know, is it a leaky building? Have they got all the consents? Is there a problem with the roof? So I think it pays to ask the questions to the agent, and they will disclose if they need to.
We're hearing a lot at the moment about how busy things are in the real estate world, Bindi. How are the agents feeling?
Yeah, well, I guess it is very, very busy right now. I mean, September we had the highest number of properties sold for 42 months. We've had 9 regions with record prices, and it's continuing at the moment. You look at the open homes and auction rooms are very, very busy. A lot of demand for housing right now. We just can't keep up with it.
But after talking to you tonight, we know to ask a lot more questions.
Well, I think you should, but also the agent will disclose if they need to as well. So, look, it's making sure that you do your homework, but the agent should disclose so you know exactly what you're in for when you're buying a property.
Thank you so much, Bindi. Good advice there. Take care.
Thanks. See you.
Yeah, some great advice there from Bindi. And look, a lot of people do freak out about paranormal activity inside of their homes. I had a friend who used to go through, if there was an open home and he was keen on buying or someone was keen on buying, he'd have a friend who would go through and start saying things like, when other people are looking at the home and the open home, and say, you know what, I used to flat here back in the 90s and there was some strange goings on. We used to have people visiting us and go, it's an old house, this, and just start talking about it to a person that they were with. Other people would overhear and think, no, that's not me. This doesn't sound like it's for me. People freak out about that sort of stuff.
How ridiculous.
Yeah, can drive the price right down.
Well, it would.
Yeah.
Good grief. Don't believe it. Don't believe it. Full disclosure, just like boyfriends.